Many patients with a positive rheumatoid factor test are sent to my office for evaluation. Is a rheumatoid factor test suggestive that you have rheumatoid arthritis? Let's find out.
Rheumatologistoncall.com.
In this video, I will discuss what is the rheumatoid factor test. Can you have a positive test but not have rheumatoid arthritis? What are the most common causes for a positive rheumatoid factor test? And if rheumatoid factor is a good screening test for rheumatoid arthritis? And in the end, we'll talk to see if we should monitor rheumatoid factor titers to assess the disease activity in rheumatoid arthritis. Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Girnita. I'm a board-certified rheumatologist and the founder of Rheumatologist OnCall. If you're new here, welcome to my YouTube channel where I educate people about autoimmune diseases such as rheumatoid arthritis, but also other types of arthritis, and most important, the methods that you have to thrive with arthritis. So don't forget to subscribe to my channel to be notified every time when I'm posting a video. First of all, what is the rheumatoid factor test? Rheumatoid factor is a test usually obtained by your doctor when they suspect an autoimmune disease. Rheumatoid factor detects certain proteins that we have in our body. Those are part of our immune system that are trying to attack certain organs, such as your joints, your muscles, and even other organs such as the eyes, lung, or the heart. Can you have a rheumatoid factor test positive and not have rheumatoid arthritis? As I mentioned, testing for rheumatoid factor is primarily done when doctors suspect rheumatoid arthritis. But rheumatoid factor is present also in other diseases, and it is not diagnostic for rheumatoid arthritis. In about 30% of patients with rheumatoid arthritis, rheumatoid factor can appear many, many years before the diagnosis is made, sometimes even 10 years before a diagnosis. What are the most common causes for a positive rheumatoid factor test? The most common cause for a high rheumatoid factor test is seen in different types of rheumatological autoimmune conditions, such as rheumatoid arthritis, as I said. In about 60 to 90% of patients, we do see a positive rheumatoid factor. Another cause, very frequent cause, is Sjögren syndrome. We do see the rheumatoid factor test positive in about 90% of patients. This is a disease that can affect primarily your eyes, your mouth, and it can cause severe dryness, but many other symptoms as well. Rheumatoid factor can also be seen in patients with lupus and mixed connective tissue disease. These are diseases that can affect multiple organs, including your skin, mucosa, your joints, and many other organs. Some patients with lupus, they will have positive rheumatoid factor, but they will also have a very aggressive inflammatory type of arthritis. We call these patients rheumatics. Rheumatoid factor is also seen in vasculitis type of diseases, such as cryoglobulinemia. This is a disease that comes very often associated with hepatitis C, and it can cause joint pain, rashes, nerve damage, and also liver disease. Rheumatoid factor can be seen in diseases such as polymyositis or dermatomyositis. These are other types of autoimmune diseases that can affect the muscles and sometimes affects the skin. But besides all these rheumatological conditions that I mentioned, high rheumatoid factor can be seen also in chronic infections. Hepatitis B and hepatitis C virus infection can be associated with high levels of rheumatoid factor. Hepatitis C is commonly associated with mixed cryoglobulinemia, as I said. And when hepatitis C is treated, that will cause the rheumatoid factor to decrease in their titer. Other causes for high rheumatoid factor is even lung fibrosis or sarcoidosis. Now, there are some patients with cancers that can have high levels of rheumatoid factor, or patients with autoimmune diseases of the liver, like primary biliary cirrhosis, that can cause a high rheumatoid factor. What is very interesting is that in about 4% of patients, normal patients without any symptoms, we do see a high rheumatoid factor. What does it mean? We still don't know. Is rheumatoid factor a good screening test, especially for rheumatoid arthritis? For patients presenting with inflammatory arthritis symptoms, such as pain, swelling, morning stiffness, in those patients, rheumatoid factor is indicated to be tested. In patients without any symptoms, rheumatoid factor is not a good screening test. Now, many patients will ask me, is titer of the rheumatoid factor important? And the answer is yes. Rheumatoid factor titer is important because the higher the titer, the higher the likelihood that you have an autoimmune disease. But as a rheumatologist, I do not base my assessment and my evaluation and my treatment on the titer of rheumatoid factor. There are some researchers that says that rheumatoid factor positive patients, they do have more aggressive disease involving multiple organs, not only the joints, but also the eyes, the lung, the heart, or they might have difficulties to respond to treatment. However, the fluctuation in the level of rheumatoid factor will not correlate with your disease activity. And as I say to my patients again and again, the test or a test is just a test without the clinical picture behind it. That is why it's important to spend enough time with patients, and that's what I do in my clinic, to understand their medical journey. If you like the educational content of my videos, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel, and you will be notified about future videos. Thank you very much, and I will see you soon.
RheumatologistOnCall.com